Hi there, welcome to my studio. Thank you for checking out this video. If you're new to my channel, my name is Siobhan and I post videos about figure drawing, specifically a dynamic and expressive approach to drawing the figure. I help figure drawing students to break through blocks in their drawing and to discover ways to get more loose and expressive. So if you're interested in figure drawing, then definitely subscribe here. Drop me a comment below to say hello and give this video a like. It really helps me out. I also write about figure drawing every week over on Substack. I'd love you to join my newsletter, so click the link in the description below. Today, I wanted to talk to you about using charcoal as a medium for figure drawing. So I'm going to explain some of the pros and cons to the various types of charcoal that you can get, and I'll share a drawing that I made today using compressed charcoal on newsprint paper. Charcoal works incredibly well to allow you to capture fast, dynamic poses, so it's great for gesture drawing. And if you want to get more expressive and responsive in your drawing overall, it can be a really great tool to work with. So let's dive into the demo of this drawing and I'll explain exactly how to approach working with charcoal. Well, first up, there are different kinds of charcoal, so not all charcoal is the same. I actually don't have any specific brand that I would recommend or that I buy necessarily, but what I always do is I always check if it is willow charcoal or compressed charcoal. So you'll find that willow charcoal is very light, both in weight and in the tone or the marks that it makes. Here you can see this is willow and you can nearly wipe it away just by touching it. Whereas compressed charcoal is much denser and it can give you a dark, heavy tone almost immediately. It's not so easy to wipe it out, but you can erase it somewhat and I'll talk more about that later. So why use charcoal for figure drawing? Well, the main reason is that it is a very expressive medium. Personally, when I'm making a gesture drawing or an expressive drawing of the figure, I prefer to use compressed charcoal rather than willow or vine charcoal. Compressed just gives you that immediate dark tones that I was talking about, so you don't have to spend time to build up areas of emphasis within your drawing. So this is exactly what I mean when I say it's an expressive medium. Essentially, it allows you to be more responsive. And so I believe in life drawing especially, it's very important to be responsive to the pose or to the model because your response is what is unique to you. And that is exactly what you want to be able to record in a drawing. It's a great skill to learn as an artist and it's something you should be aware of and try to develop. Charcoal gives you the capability to explore that responsiveness in a very direct and immediate way. Now, it also matters what paper you choose to draw on, because not all paper is going to be a good match for this drawing tool. I love to draw on newsprint paper because it works so well with charcoal, and I tend to avoid paper that's either too smooth, like cartridge paper, or too textured, like watercolor paper. Something like newsprint, while not the best quality paper, is very nice to draw on. And since you're learning this medium anyway and you're experimenting, you know, it's a great option because it's cheap and you can use a lot of it and you can practice without feeling that you're wasting good quality paper. Compressed charcoal comes in long sticks, which you can just break up into smaller pieces. And this gives you the ability to use the side for quick, immediate tonal marks, which is wonderful when you're trying to get the whole figure down quickly as a gesture, or, you know, as a first response that you can then work up into a more finished drawing like I'm doing here. The tonal marks help you to match out large sections, and you can go back over that later and refine things. Obviously, that's good for those shadow shapes to get them down quickly, but in many ways, this is less about marking in shadows and more about just capturing an overall gesture of the pose. I often feel that working with a stick of charcoal instead of a pencil means that you have much, much less control over your marks, and sometimes that can be a good thing because it allows you, again, to be more responsive. Over time, you'll learn to use this, you know, stick of charcoal in a very intentional and meaningful way. So you might at first be just making marks kind of all over the place and not really have the same control as you would with a pencil. But with practice, you can start to push your charcoal to get the exact right marks where you want them that match the way you're looking at your reference or the model. What might seem like unwieldy or uncontrolled at first becomes all about matching your eye-hand coordination, and it can lead to a very nuanced, very controlled experience with practice. The beauty of charcoal is that you can also use the very edge or the very corner of a piece of charcoal for fine lines in order to draw contours and edges. This is another remarkable aspect of this medium. In a beat, you can switch from those broad, dark tonal marks to ultra-fine, subtle line work. The possibility of having these kinds of varied marks and tones in one drawing will make your work feel very powerful and dynamic. This is what gives your drawing a rhythm, that thing you hear so many people talking about. Using varied marks is like changing up the tempo of a drawing and making sure that you don't just have one monotonous note that never changes throughout. Not a lot of drawing tools can give you these kinds of varied marks in such a quick and direct way. Now, compressed charcoal can get very messy as you work with it. It'll get all over your hands. You know, you'll tend to smudge your paper as well. So my advice is to always start out as light as you can. Work very lightly in the beginning. The temptation really is to go in almost immediately with dark marks and to place shadow shapes down and get the details down right away. But even if you just plot those things out in your drawing, do so very lightly until you're absolutely sure that you have everything in the right place, and then you can always work things up with more emphasis. It's possible to erase compressed charcoal, but if you go in too dark too quickly, you might not be able to erase those marks altogether. But overall, my advice would be start out very light to ensure that you don't get dark in your drawing too quickly. So I hope this video was helpful, and I hope you got some useful information about working with charcoal in your figure drawings. I know that most figure drawing students are working in their sketchbook, especially when they're drawing from reference. And in that case, people mostly work with drawing tools like pencils or pens, and working with charcoal in a sketchbook could get very, very messy. But I'd encourage you, next time you go to life drawing, bring along some newsprint paper and try out drawing with compressed charcoal. I think you'll be amazed at the difference it makes to your drawing. And if you do that, please let me know in the comments below. Also, let me know what your preferred medium is for figure drawing. I'd love to hear from you. So that's it for me for today. Don't forget to join my newsletter on Substack if you want weekly posts about figure drawing. Give this video a like, and thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.